And today on the live stream in the Eastwood Garage, we're going to be going over some of our most popular cutting tools. Some you may not even known existed, like that throatless shear. Here's a straight throatless shear. We're going to go over some simple tools that are definite must-haves for an auto restoration. Electric shears, snips, cut-off wheels, air nibblers, and reciprocating saws. So let's get started. So, like I said, today we're going to be going over a bunch of tools that you're going to need in a restoration or just for any kind of metal fab. And some of them maybe you didn't know existed, so we're going to show them to you, show you some examples. We're going to cut some metal with a lot of these tools, including the plasma cutter. But first, let's take a look at some of the stuff we've got here. Some of the stuff we're probably not going to use. We got two forms of shears, pneumatic shears and electric shears. I prefer the electric shears. These will cut up to 18 gauge, and we're going to use these in a couple minutes. Right here we have the pneumatic shears. These will cut 20 gauge. We have a cutoff wheel. This one's pretty unique because you can see how long it is. But another interesting part about this cutoff wheel is that you can reverse the direction. So typically they'll spin one direction, where this one you can adjust the knob and it'll spin the other way, which is nice. It'll keep you from, if you're in a tight spot where you're reaching back in, the length's nice to reach in, but it's also nice that you can switch a direction so the sparks aren't flying in your face, as well as adjusting the direction to make it easier to cut the metal. You know, typical if you're doing a restoration, you'll have a cutoff wheel like that. And here's one, if you don't have this and you're restoring a car, you need one of these little reciprocating saws. This one here's got some actually fairly aggressive teeth on it. It's probably a 24. Usually you'd probably use about a 32. If you can get in and see that, that's really aggressive. We offer a few different blades, some tooth sizes. So you're going to generally want a finer one. But the reason these are so nice, I'll go over here to the Camaro. You've probably seen videos where we're cutting stuff out. Anything on a restoration, this is about the only place you can get in, about the only tool you could really use to cut something like that out. It's great for cutting out patches. So if you're restoring a car, absolutely you're going to need one of these. So, and if you see a lot of our videos, this is one tool you're going to see used a lot. And we're also going to show you the electric shears. We're going to give you some tips on left and right cut aviation snips. It does not mean they cut to the left and if you want to cut to the right. So we're going to show you that. And we're going to go over an air nibbler, which is a pretty cool tool, especially if you're doing some patchwork. So first thing, we're going to cut some metal with the shears. We're going to start here with a straight shear. Now this is actually a throatless shear. And I got a bolt in here for safety. That means that with this shear, not only can you do something like this, let me put a piece of metal in here. So not only can you just simply slice a piece of metal like that. Now this will cut metal up to 11 gauge in length. And it's going to cut shorter pieces up to 3/16. Cool feature, you can actually cut rod. It's got a hole right here, if you can see that. So watch the lens here, actually, because it will spit this piece out. So if you got some rod, you can actually shear rod up to 3/16, which makes it really cool. So, but like I said, it's throatless. So let me grab another piece here and show you. So what that means is it's not just one pull and you're done like I just did. You can get it set up here, right? And you can work it, pull. And as you can see, you can keep pushing. And by this design, you can see it pushes the metal down here and out of the way. So you can just keep going and pushing the metal. So if you had a couple friends helping you, you would actually be able to cut, say, like a whole 4x8 sheet. You could just push a whole 4x8 sheet through this and just keep cutting. And just cut it in half or cut off whatever you need. So it's a pretty cool tool that we have here at Eastwood. Now, something similar is this economy throatless shear, often known as a Beverly shear. It's got a safety pin. Let me actually throw this safety pin back in this one. So with this, just like the other shear, you can cut straight lengths. We have replaceable jaws for them. You know, you're cutting metal. Jaws are going to wear out. So, I know this isn't the most exciting thing watching cut metal, but you can see that you can make a pretty, and like the other one, get around, you can see it's the same thing. This is also a throatless design. So it's like the straight shear, it's pushing it down out of the way. So again, like the straight shear, this means you could also cut like a whole 4x8 sheet if you wanted to, because it's just going to keep pushing it out of the way and keep moving it. Now this one, you're only going to be able to cut up to about 3. So on a rest, this would be fine, 18 gauge stainless. Whereas the straight shear, you can cut up to a 11 gauge and 3/16 in small widths. But another cool feature about this is that you can cut arcs. Like say you wanted to make a wheel well. Now this obviously is a miniature version, but if you go to our YouTube channel, you'll be able to see where we did a video where we cut out a full size arch. So like if you were making wheel tubs, it would be the side arch, and then you would have your actual tub over the top of the tire here. This is a miniature version because I don't want you guys to have to sit through me cutting this all day. So, but we're gonna get started here and you're gonna see how it works. With a glare in here. I should have done this in a different color. The black's easy for you guys to see. So I'm gonna try to do it as fast as I can. And actually, you can pull the handle. You can take off bigger pieces than you would think usually. But you're gonna start seeing this metal, because the way this works, you're gonna start seeing it come out the back. If I can get camera guy. And if you guys are watching, we really want to know what time is the best time for you guys to watch live videos. Is, as you can see, now you can see how this is working. Right here, you can see coming out of the back. Now, I don't want to get too screwed up here because I'm starting to try to show and talk more than I'm concentrating. But anyways, yeah, what time I want to know, is it 9 a.m.? Is it noon? Is it 3 in the afternoon? Those are the three basic times we can do these live streams. If you saw on Friday, we actually did one working on that Camaro we just saw. So we just came to you live. So there you go. So, I mean, I'm sure it wasn't the most exciting thing you saw, but right there would be an arch for a wheel well. Granted, like I said, it's a miniature version, but if you were making wheel wells, you know, that with this one tool, not only can you make straight cuts, but you could also make an arch like that. And, like I said, you can make pretty good straight cuts, too. So, all right, what's next? Oh, electric shears. Let me do the electric shears. So these are another probably definite must-have tool in a restoration. These things are great. The only electric shears I bought here at Eastwood. And I'd never used them before, and I bought two sets of spare jaws. I think that was 3 years ago. I don't think I've ever put another set of jaws in them. And I've cut many, many, many feet doing patch panels. I've cut a roof off of a car, a rusty roof. I really thought the rusty roof that's what would wear the jaws. I mean, I understand like not wearing them cutting brand new metal, but when you cut rust, you think it would. But these things are great. Not only for this, but for cutting metal off a car. So, the only thing is, it does take out a fairly wide area, but we'll show you how they work. So usually when you get started, the only thing you gotta watch is this. A lot of times I just try to bend it out of the way to try to get at the coil. And if you get it to just coil like that, I mean, I've cut an 8-foot length, and you end up with a coil about this long, just a perfect coil, and they work that smooth. I don't think there's any reason to keep the show cutting huge pieces, but. So, like I said, these are available in electric and pneumatic. I prefer the electric because you're always near a plug. I like the way they cut over pneumatic. And the electric ones have this feature here. So say you're in a tight spot, you can loosen up these jaws right here. And we do sell the replacement jaws. So you can actually, so if you needed to get an area where you couldn't get in, You can actually adjust the jaws like this. I'm probably working too fast for a cameraman here today. So, or you can turn them back like that. And all it is just a tightness one. So I'll tighten these back up so the next guy grabs them. Doesn't think it'll probably be me though. Doesn't blame me or blame the tool for a bad cut. So, I guess what else we got? We got the air nibbler yet. Show you that. Now, and we got the snips too. I'll grab all of them, bring all the stuff over. So, let me grab the air nibbler. So I've never seen one of these. These are pretty cool. They're cool because you can make a lot of... Let me get in here. There they work. So if you want to cut a straight line, you can cut a straight line with them. But if you need to cut a piece out, you can make really sharp turns like I just did there. I'll try to do it here so you can really see it. So if you've never seen one of these, that's what makes these things so unique. Oops. So, and like I said, say you're doing a patch pattern on a car, you can drill a hole, put this in the hole, and start from there. So that's another nice way. Cool tool. Got it, you know, when you have it, yeah, you'll definitely find uses for it. So now the snips are our last thing here. Like I said, a lot of people think left means you're cutting to the left, right means you're cutting to the right. Now, red is left. It's not right red. Left is red. Some people remember because the words are shorter. I remember because green light, you can turn right on a green light. Right means go. Green means go. Green means right. If that's too complicated for you, you can just look on the handle here for the R, or the handle here for the L, and it'll tell you which way. So basically you got a piece of metal. So these are right cut, that means the metal's gonna come off to the right. So when you're holding them, get them turned around here. So when you're holding them, you're gonna see what I mean. You see how the metal comes off to the right? So if you're gonna, so say you got this piece close and you just need to trim it down. So you're close, you're gonna trim it down, you would use these on this side to trim it close. It's gonna peel it off. Now the left cut are going to do the opposite. Am I working too fast here? Okay, I probably am. So the left cut, say you did something, you're making a patch panel, and usually you're going to cut them a little long and then trim them down because you're not going to add metal to the patch panel. You got to start over. So you would do this, and like you said, see how it's going to the left? And there's a simple little tip for using these aviation tin snips. And we've got a bunch. If you go to Eastwood, not only do we have these, we have offset ones. So they're pretty cool for getting the spots. And we have some straight cuts, which some people like. And the last thing, I guess, do we have any questions before we get to the plasma cutter? Now, don't forget, tomorrow we have a powder coating demo. We're going to show you, at the end of this video, we're going to show you some of the stuff that we're going to demo tomorrow. We did some stuff ahead of time to show you, and then we're going to do it again tomorrow during the demonstration. And also, at the end of this video, if you're watching on YouTube recorded, we'll have links for this stuff so you can visit Eastwood and check it out more. But is there anything, Scott, or getting it all answered?
Right now I've been able to answer it all right here on the computer, and it appears to be unanimous that everybody wants us to stay at 3 o'clock for our times.
Okay. And I forgot to mention Scott. He's over there. We're down a person today on camera, so I was doing double duty to start off. But Scott, he's our lead tech, so when you call in here, he's the person you're gonna get to talk to, and he's usually answering questions during these live streams. So, plasma cutting. Oh, get my other shades on. Really simple. Plug it in. This is the Versacut 60. It runs on 240. Down below, we got a Versacut 40. Versacut 40 is great for auto restoration. You're going to cut sheet metal up to 3/8.
When plugged into 220.
The Versacut 40 is nice for a lot of people because it'll operate on 240 or 120. there's an Accord that'll allow you to plug it into your standard like 120-volt household current. Now, you will not be cutting as thick, but I got the Versacut 60. I love it. It's great for anything you're going to do on an auto restoration, from sheet metal all the way up to if you got to cut tabs and brackets for a frame or anything you're doing. And if you decide you need to build a bridge, it'll handle that too, because we have cut 7/8. We used this on a live stream recently, and we cut everything from, I think we were cutting 5/8 that day without any problem, to sheet metal on one setting. So there's really nothing complicated about using a plasma cutter. And you get to wear cool shades when you're using it. So anyways, so I got some 1/8 inch here just to show you. So if you're not familiar, we've got a lot of videos using this, and you will see us cutting up to about 3/4 inch steel plate with the plasma. And as you notice, we're cutting here on this plasma table. So if you're thinking about getting a plasma, you already have one. If you didn't know tables like this existed, the cool thing is you can cut right on it. So if you're cutting something thick, it's not falling off the end of your table and putting a big dent in your cement. And these slats are replaceable. So when you cut through them, you can just flip them over. So you doubles the life. And then when they're out, you can get more slats right here at Eastwood, or you could go probably buy, you could just go buy the metal and make your own if you really wanted to. But I recommend getting them here at Eastwood. All right, so let's get started. Let's cut this. All right, so here we go. We got a ground cable hooked up. Are you ready, Dave? So there you go. Or if you cut a piece off, it falls down through the slats anyways. I should have cut off a longer piece. So now we're gonna go right to sheet metal. Ready? And so, like I said, one setting, it couldn't be easier. All of our plasmas work the same, the Versacut 60, the 40, or the 20. I definitely say, you know, the 40 is a decent one. If you can get the 60, get the 60, just because it's, you know, if you decide you want to get into some thicker metal fab, it'll do up to 7/8, and it will do up to 7/8. So I guess that's it. If we don't have any questions, Scott's answering. I'm going to show you what's going on with powder coating tomorrow, because this is an absolute must-see live video, because we're going to have chrome powder and everything else. So let's walk over and check that out, some examples here. All right, so what we got here is we've got this valve cover. We did, first it was coated in white and in orange. That's on the left side. The right side is just over chrome. So that's the same color. That's our same color, orange chrome, just one's over white, one is over the chrome. Right here is the blue, same thing. It's our rally blue, one side's over white, other side's over chrome. And right here is our chrome powder. And tomorrow at 3:00, we're gonna be spraying that chrome powder and show you how good it looks. So make sure you tune in tomorrow at 3:00.